Hello everyone! In this video, Miss Ayu wants to tell you narrative fiction story about the legend of Rawa. So let's check it out! In ancient times, in a village called Ngasem Village, there lived a Javanese woman named Endang Sawitri. She had a child named Baru Klinding, but her child was not in human form, but a dragon. As time went by, Baru Klinting grew older. He began to think who his real father was. He dared to ask his mother this question. She couldn't bear to see his son who kept asking curious questions. Finally, the mother answered that his father was actually a king named Salokantara. Now, the king Ki Hajar Salokantara was meditating in a cave on the slopes of Mount Telomoyo. If Baru Klinting wanted to meet the king, Baru Klinting must show him the Klinting on Baru Klinting's neck, because the Klinting was a relic of the king. After getting the blessing from his mother, Baru Klinting immediately rushed to look for the king Ki Hajar Salokantara, who was his father all this time. Baru Klinting immediately went to climb the slopes of Mount Telomoyo. Finally, Baru Klinting arrived at the slopes of Mount Telomoyo and found the cave where the king Ki Hajar Salokantara was meditating. Baru Klinting then tried to come into the cave to meet the king. Finally, Baru Klinting met the king who was meditated. Baru Klinting then tried to greet the king and said that Baru Klinting was the king's son. The Klinting, or the bell, was the evidence that Baru Klinting was the king's son. The king was shocked about Baru Klinting's statement. However, the king wanted to admit Baru Klinting as his son if Baru Klinting accepted the king's request. The king Ki Hajar Salokantara wanted Baru Klinting to round the Telomoyo mountain and meditated for a year. Then the king admitted that Baru Klinting was his own son. Baru Klinting then accepted the king's request. He started to go round the Telomoyo mountain until his body was covered with grass and trees. As the time went by, several residents of Patok village were hunting on the hillside. They wanted to hunt deer as a feast for the earth alms party after the harvest period was over. However, until dusk began to come, they did not see a single deer. They almost gave up. At that time, one of the residents saw a large snake which was none other than Baru Klinting. They finally cut the snake and took the meat to the village. The next day, Baru Klinting's mat was processed together with the residents in the village with various delicious and abundant preparations. The residents rejoiced. Then, in the afternoon, the Earth Alms party was celebrated in the main square. There was so much delicious food there, none other than Baru Klinting's mat. The residents looked enthusiastic, happy, and ate with great gusto. A few moments later, a small child who looked shabby asked the villagers for food because he had not eaten for days. But the villagers were very stingy and did not want to share food with the shabby little child. A few moments later, a small child who looked shabby asked the villagers for food because he had not eaten for days, but the villagers were very stingy and did not want to share food with the shabby little child. They didn't know that the shabby little child was the Baru Klinting whose mat they ate. After the shabby little child was not given food by the residents, finally, this child went to a house to ask for food. It turned out that in the small house, there lived a kind old widow. The old widow fed this little child until this little child was full. After this little child was full, this child asked the old widow to immediately climb into the mortar when she heard a roar to save herself. The old widow complied with the request of the little wrecked child. Then, the tattered little boy returned to the village square. He tried to ask for food back, but was rejected by the residents. The boy was angry, and he took a tree branch. He stuck the tree branch into the ground and challenged the residents to pull it out. The residents laughed at the tattered little boy's challenge. One by one, the locals tried to pull out the twig, but they all failed to pull it out. After a few moments, the tattered little boy came forward to pull it out and said that he was the Baru Klinting, the incarnation of a dragon whose flesh they ate. Baru Klinting deliberately tested the residents to share food, but the residents didn't want to share it. It was the time for Baru Klinting to give punishment for the residents' treatment of him. Baru Klinting finally pulled out the twig. From where the twig had been removed, very strong water came out. The longer, the water got stronger, and it caused a flash flood. In an instant, the village was submerged in flood water and became a swamp lake. All the residents drowned. Only one, the old widow, survived because she was kind enough to feed Baru Klinting. the village that was submerged in flood water and became a swamp lake was called as Rawa Bening. It was full of fishes, and so many people loved fishing there.
Well, everyone and my students, that's all the narrative fiction story about the legend of Rawa Bening. As we can see from the story, we can take a moral value that we must be a kind-hearted person and help each other, so that we will get a kindness things from what we have done. If someone needs our help, help them. Don't be selfish, okay? Well, everyone, hope you like the narrative fiction story about Rawa Bening. And see you on my next videos. Bye-bye! Thank you.